the enjoyment of others, we ask that pagers and cell phones be turned to silent operation. The show you are about to see involves sudden sound and pyrotechnic effects. It contains atypical food ingestion and close contact with animals and insects that some guests may find discomforting. We also ask that there be no smoking in the stadium at any time. Thank you, and enjoy the show.
Welcome to Fear Factor Live! Hi everyone, my name is Ginger and I'm the producer here at Fear Factor Live. With me I've got Rocco on the camera, my production assistant Katie, and my crew in the booth and backstage. Put your hands together for my team! And we are so glad you joined us here, because what you are about to see is the most exciting and daring show we've ever presented here at Universal Orlando. This show is the first of its kind anywhere. Never before have we used actual park guests to participate in extreme stunts that you will see here today. Now, all of these stunts are very real, and they were designed with the help of the creators of the hit TV series, Fear Factor. So you know it's going to be intense. But that's not all. Because this is live, you are all just as much part of the show as the contestants. As a matter of fact, we've given you a line to say in the show. Whenever you hear me or my host Kevin say, "Oh, by the way, we need to hear all of you loudly say, there's one more thing." It's going to try. We'll see how loud you guys are. "Oh, by the way,
there's one more thing."
Pretty good. Keep that up. And actually, there is one more thing. I have some last minute casting to do to get some of you directly involved in the action. So, who wants to factor a little extra fear for our contestants? If you want to participate, raise your hand really high for me. If I choose you, come down to Katie. She's going to hook you up with front row VIP seating. Now, for this first stunt, I need someone small. I need a little kid. Way back there in the Under Armour shirt, the black and red shirt. That's you. Yeah, come on now. Now, I need two people who want to make a splash. I'm afraid to get a little bit wet, maybe a lot wet. You two right there on the end. Yep. Now, I need two people who want to control the weather for our contestants. In the green, right there. And right there in the Star Wars shirt. Come on now. Now, I need two people really good at video games. Where are my gamers? Anybody in the back? Gamer? Gamer right there in the green shirt and way back there, sir. Yes, come on down. Now I need two teams of two. You have to have a partner for this. If you have a partner, raise your partner's hand. You want to go as partners? That's my one team right there, right there. And you two right there, come on down. And last but not least, I need a big, loud, enthusiastic audience. Let me hear you make some noise. Great. Well, just like on the show, we count down all of our stunts here with a 3, 2, 1, go. As a matter of fact, that's how I'm starting this show. So as we get the all clear, there it is. So that leaves me with one final question for you. Are you ready to see our contestants face their fears?
Yeah!
Then count it down with me in 3, 2, 1, go.
I'm Kevin Frady. And this is Fear Factor. The stunts you're about to see were designed and supervised by trained professionals. They are extremely dangerous and should never be attempted by anyone, anywhere, anytime. Contestants, you were chosen for one reason, and that's to prove that fear is not perfect setup for that first stunt. Let's take a look at some interviews they shot beforehand, hear what they had to say then.
Hi, my name is Autumn. I'm from Jacksonville, Florida, and I'm going to win because today is my birthday.
Hi, my name is Maddie. I'm from Jacksonville, Florida, and the reason I'm going to win is because I'm better than Autumn.
I'm Phil from Waukesha, Wisconsin. I'm going to win because I'm quick on my feet.
Hi, my name is Brian from Boston, Massachusetts, and I'm a competition beast.
I'm Robert from Rhode Island, and I'm going to win because greatness beyond him has him become greatness.
Well, that's how our contestants sounded before the show. I wonder how they're feeling right now. Just to remind everybody what they're in for, let's take a look at some highlights from the hit NBC series, Fear Factor.
Slide off as Phil found out.
And here comes the win.
Autumn down. Let's
Since you won, you get to pick your partner for the next round. But no, whoever you pick, if you go to the finals, they become your competition. Who's it going to be?
Brian.
You're going with... Wait, you hit Phil and you said Brian. You're going with Brian. All right.
I'm the point.
Yeah. All right. It's going to be Robert and Brian taking on Phil and Autumn in the semi.
Reminiscent of the days when, as punishment, they would bury people up to their neck in the sand and leave them to the mercy of the desert. Emily, have a seat.
Here you go, Emily. This next stunt, a lot of people find disturbing. We're strapping Emily into this chair for her own protection. Because in just a couple of minutes, Janet, our critter wrangler here, she's going to put some of these critters on Emily's head. Now, to determine which of those critters ends up on Emily's head, I give you the Wheel of Fear. You're welcome. We got cockroaches, snakes, tarantulas, and emperor scorpions.
Yes, they are the nasty ones. Now, traveling with Emily today is her good friend John. Hey, John, come on up here and decide your friend's fate.
Yeah, we're going to see how good a friend. Yeah. All right, give it a spin. All right, what do you guys want to see? Roaches, snakes. All right, it was a healthy spin. Nice to do that, John.
Yes.
On your head, and if you can, avoid making eye contact with them. They see that as a sign of aggression. So all we need to know is, are you ready for this?
All right, John, that's right. Keep that camera rolling, but we are going to lend your friend Emily some moral support. Be prepared for a long car ride home.
You guys ready? Yeah, you're not the one sitting in this chair. All right, let's do this in
three, two,
professional with days of experience under her belt. Very capable and competent hands here. There you go. Fortunately, with the weather about to change, it's made them a lot more docile.
And that's it.
There you go, last one. All right, there you go. She did it. Good job. Same piece of cake. How was that, Emily? It was good. Safe, all right? Check. Just close your eyes. sure what's under there.
Check it out.
When we say go, you're gonna race over to the tank and put your hand inside. Avoid being bitten, pull out a beanbag. Come back over, toss the beanbags to your partners, they catch them in the buckets. The team that transfers the most bags, one at a time in 30 seconds, will get an advantage going into the second half of this stunt. Got it? Oh, by the way,
soaking them with these high-intensity water cannons. Let's hear for Giovanni and Gage!
Red team ready? Blue team ready? Audience, you guys ready? Here we go in
3, 2, 1, go!
And away they go. Blue team with the first bag. Right down here, guys. We're gonna line them up diagonally across from their partners and then tether them directly to the stage. Two reasons. We tether them to the stage because that's gonna limit the range of mobility they have to catch these. We have them diagonally across so that we get the maximum loft out of each throw. Now, all that being said, first couple of rows, right in here, and right in here, heads up. It's not at all uncommon to end up with an octopus in your lap.
Set left, set right.
All right, hoist them up, guys. Toss them down one at a time. Like I said, red team, you won the first half. You have 4 to the blue team's 3. Let's see who's going to the finals. All right, it looks like we're all
clear left.
Red side, you guys ready? Weak, blue side, what you got? There we go, let's watch the octopi fly in 3, 2, 1, go! Oh, blue team strong on that first throw, red team connecting. Oh, nice catch, Robert. Blue team just trying to get on the board here, and that's not gonna happen. Meanwhile, the red team 4 for 4 on their way to the finals.
Congratulations,
nice
red team.
Done.
Made that look pretty easy.
Here you go, Robert. Now, I've been doing this show for some time, and I don't see a lot of the one-handed approach there. It came in handy. No pun intended. It came in very handy. Yeah. Be quiet. Yes. Now, you two, you worked very well as a team. You're like, no, I want Brian. I want Brian. I don't know if there was any strategy there, thinking he can get me to the finals, but once we get there, I got this.
Absolutely.
What's going to happen?
I'm going to win. Plain and simple. I'm the best here, and that's what I'm going to do.
Oh, Brian. He says,
I'm the best here, and that's exactly what I'm going to do.
What happens?
Arnold Schwarzenegger's got nothing on me.
All right, you and Fabio are going to battle this out in just a minute. Guys, head right off that way. We'll get you all set. set up. How about a hand though for the blue team here, a valiant effort. Turn around, gang. Well, I can't think of a better birthday present than to throw dead octopus, can you?
No, I really can.
Yeah?
It's pretty great.
Yeah? Well, happy birthday.
Thank you.
Yeah. How was it?
Oh, it was a lot of fun.
Well, good, good. Unfortunately, gang, we only have one winner. The walk of shame.
So long, guys.
Now, while they're getting set up for the finals, let's see who has the stomach for this next part.
Joining us up here right now, I have three very brave volunteers. You remember John, we have Autumn and Scott. Let's hear it for
them. A lot of Autumns around today. Well, it's November, it's to be expected. If you're at all familiar with the show, you know it ain't Fear Factor until there is something interesting to eat. So we decided to call this next part, Guess What's Crawling to Dinner.
Oh, let's see what's on our menu today. Our first course, Seafood Surprise. A fragrant combination of rotten oysters, clams, octopus, fish heads, and tails all in a nice, slimy, sticky jizz.
Smells like low tide. Here, come on over here. Don't be scared.
Our second course, Mystery Meat Medley. Now, this contains the remnants from the meatpacking plant. I don't exactly know what's in it. They just kind of scrape it off the floor and give it to us.
Well, can't walk around with dirty floors, I suppose.
No, no. And then we're going to wash all of that down with just a little bit of sour milk.
Well, that's not bad.
Really?
No, we got lumps! Yay! It's shocking.
Here we go.
Hey, whoa, whoa, whoa. What are you doing? Stop.
Blending.
I know what a blender does.
Okay.
You're doing Serpenter and milk and Fear Factor, food challenge.
Are you making fun of my food choices?
I'm saying that is weak.
Okay, but remember we're at a theme park?
So what?
So we don't expect these people to eat what we make them eat on the show.
If I may. Folks, do you think this is Fear Factor quality? Do you think? Oh, I don't know. Maybe they should eat what we eat on TV?
Bring along a little Fear Factor Live party mix.
There we go.
It's a disgusting combination of crickets from super feet by grasshoppers. Gonna give it that little extra snap, crackle.
Okay. Why are you holding out on me?
I'm
gonna cut 10 minutes off the show, right?
I'm messing with you.
All right. You know what though, gang? Just in case this doesn't work out the way we drew it up, these are the official Chuck buckets here. Pretty self-explanatory. It's a crappuccino, Scott. Crappuccino. All right.
Had to warn.
All right. All right, gang, listen up. It's pretty cutthroat here and simple. 30 seconds. Whoever finishes first wins. All right? Scott, you ready? You're doing it anyway. Autumn? All right. Chuck, you're too ready. That's scary. All right. You guys ready? Let's count down. You've got this. Come on. slide down the pole, go over to your car, start up your car. The ignition for the car is located on the right-hand passenger side. After you start the car, stay seated. We're going to raise you up 25 feet. When I say go, go out onto the hood. Release the three yellow flags on the front. Then go to the back seat. Pick up your rocket launcher. Aim for the bullseye in the center of the stage. First one that hits it will be the champion of Fear Factor Live. Robert, head on over. Brian, head on over. Oh, my.